Hello and welcome to another video of bonus material of our Advanced Piano Tricks course, Volume 1. So we can see trick number one here in our index upper structure, 2 major over dominant 7. I click on it, it goes right to that trick. All the pertinent information is right there. Even better, if I just scan that QR code, I go right to the video and I can watch that on my phone while checking out the content on my tablet or any other device that I might have. So the first thing I want to point out is the way that we're voicing the dominant chord on the left hand, which is only playing 3 notes, the root and the 2 guide tones, the 3 and the flat 7. We're showing this voicing on the music notation at the bottom of the lesson's notes. But I think we can take a much deeper, more advanced look into this left hand voicing and how a simple evolution of it can drastically change the way that you use this trick. Remember, the only notes that we really need to get the basic sound of a dominant chord are the guide tones. Not even the root is necessary. Sure, once we include the root, we get a complete picture of the chord, but we don't really need it to produce a dominant sounding chord. One important thing to notice is that there are 2 possible voicings with the root on the bass. 1-3 flat 7 and 1 flat 7-3. If you look at the demo, you'll immediately realize that the choice of playing a 1-3 flat 7 or a 1 flat 7-3 depends on several factors, such as the range, the key, and the size of the voicing. An F7 sounds pretty good here as 1-3 flat 7. It also sounds nice here as a 1 flat 7-3. And it's playable as long as your hand is not too small. But up here, the A in the 1 flat 7-3 voicing might be too high. And a D flat 7 in a 1 flat 7-3 voicing is a pretty tough voicing to play due to its size. But a great solution would be to remove the root. In fact, without playing the root on our left hand, this trick would create a much more ambiguous and interesting sound. This would make the trick quite a bit more challenging, not only because the sound would be more ambiguous, but also because taking the root out makes a chord much harder to play. If I play a C7 using only E and B flat, I still need to think of the C, but I'm not playing it at all. Just know that you can take this trick to another level by just removing the root from your left hand. An interesting fact is that after we've removed the root, we can reconsider the chord as being another dominant chord a tritone away. So E and B flat could be a C7 or an F sharp 7. In the case of F sharp 7, our 2 major triad upper structure on the right hand, D, would turn into a flat 6 upper structure, thus changing a dominant 7 sharp 11 into a dominant 7 sharp 9 flat 13. Even more interesting is that when we voice this chord as E, B flat, D, F sharp, and A, we're suggesting another one of the tricks in this book, trick number 10, which is the major triad on the flat 7 of a minor 7 flat 5 chord. And it's this perspective that shows a very important relationship between these 3 chords, C7, F sharp 7, and E minor 7 flat 5. As you work on this trick in different keys and think of this rootless perspective, you'll start finding this 3 chord relationship in every key. This perspective will open a whole lot of new doors for reinterpretation of harmonic progressions and opportunities for reharmonization you wouldn't have seen otherwise. I hope that was helpful. Remember that now, every time you use the QR code from the book to watch the lesson, you'll find this video next to it as bonus material. By the way, click here if you want to watch the original lesson for this trick. Today's sound is created using one simple trick. Can you tell what it is?